Welcome everybody back into your coverage of Starladder Season 3, where we have Na'Vi now going up against Empire. Empire, the team when this competition started that everyone said, man, these guys are freaking sweet! Now they're going up against Na'Vi, a team who has not played a single game in this competition. Let's jump ourselves over, because I know everybody loves watching the draft, especially when you've got a guy like Puppy doing one draft on one side, and Goblike doing the draft on the other. Should be one hell of a game, because we had ourselves an action-packed game between Moscow 5 and Virtus Pro just earlier tonight. In fact, it was our previous game. If you missed that one out, the VODs will be available later on this evening. It is action-packed is an understatement for it. As far as this game goes, we've got no idea what really to expect. We can tell you that it's not the full Na'Vi roster this evening. They're using 4 out of their 5. So Dendi, Light of Heaven, Art, as well as Puppy are the 4. And then DK is actually Phobos. He is the stand-in for Na'Vi this evening. Empire using their normal lineup of Goblin, Silent, Scandal, Blow Your Brain, as well as a Funic to take off their full lineup. So far in the bans, Darkseer as well as Prophet being taken out. Puppy, he doesn't have first pick. That goes to Empire. So maybe we might see him just give up the Naga. But as we saw in our last game, Naga, such an easy setup when you got yourself a Naga on the field. And really risking that Naga. Puppy is the only captain out there that really feels that it's worth it to risk not actually picking up the Naga. Lycan banned out now by Goblack, and Morphling will be the quick ban out by Puppy. So Goblack, you've got your choice right now. You'll give away the Enigma if they do pick it up, and it's possible they'll just let it slide. They might just let it slide to go through the next pull. This is the problem when you're sitting at the situation. It's like, sweet, I get the hero I want. Wait, what am I going to give them in return? There's Chen. There's Enigma. There's Tidehunter. There's Invoker. There's Temple or Assassin's going to be available. All of these heroes are currently available in the pool. And Puppy is able to pick out from 2 of them after this. And Goblack, we're going to see what we saw in our last game before, where it's like, we'll let Lashrak go, and then we saw Naga plus Enigma, Naga instant counterpick, and there's Puppy picking up the Naga Siren. Will he couple it with the Enigma, or are they going to try and do something else and maybe pick up a Chen? Goblack has got to have a plan if he's going to let that Naga Siren through, because the plan in the last game didn't work. Didn't work by any scenario, and we are going to see exactly the same draft as our last game. Well, Lashrak is first pick up, and then Naga, Siren, Enigma follow directly after. The only question is going to be what Puppy wants to couple it with, because Morphling was banned out, which means he won't have that option. But because Templar Assassin is through the pool, he might just make that his third pickup and say, we're cool with this. And Goldblack, he's got to look at his jungle right now, so Chen's going to be his main option. 5 seconds. Got to keep what keeps them alive going. So Chen might be it, and they're going to take Rubick, because, oh, got to remember too, Rubick was banned out in the last one, so we were talking about the importance of what Rubick is capable of doing, which is basically anything the other team can do. Can even duel off ultimates. He can be Naga and Enigma all in one, may just steal Naga's ultimate, and then Enigma comes through and wants instantly Black Hole, and Rubick can then swipe that little sucker out as well. So Rubick, Lashrak, and Chen will be the pickups here from Empire. And Na'Vi might also see this as an opportunity. They know Rubick is going to be running as a solo or a core hero in this scenario. So Templar Assassin won't have to worry about things like Venomancers or like Queen of Pains. Mainly because both Chen and Lashrak and Rubick, you've got your 2 supports and 1 core in that. Which means there is no way you can easily pick that counterpick for him unless Rubick starts running offlane. And that's a possibility, but not the easiest one. And Puppy in the end decides to go with Shadow Shaman. So he's looking for Hex and Lockdown as well as the wards. That's a lot of abilities for Rubick to swipe. But it's also good burst damage early on. Get that shock up a couple of levels. And maybe they're feeling that Empire is going to be going for that Windrunner on the offlane, and then you look towards the Shackles. So you'll have Net to set up, Shackles to follow up, and Enigma with the Malifaux stun. And already you got yourself a very, very aggressive, well, what is a defensive tri-lane if you want to look at it that way. But can be aggressive at the same time, and Goblack instantly bans out the mid-solo. Kind of really surprised that Puppy still wanted to pick up that Shadow Shaman. There's many other heroes that are capable of doing the same thing, unless they're thinking something different with that Shadow Shaman. And that's like looking to go towards the middle lane. But that third ban, that third pickup from Puppy, just so early in the mix. And now starts to ban out the hard carry heroes of Empire. But Goldblack also started doing the same. He started taking out Templar Assassin because he realizes that, well, Puppy is missing the off lane up. Beastmaster would probably be a pretty nice ban for him too. But then again, Beastmaster and you got Rubick on the field. It's a smorgasbord of abilities for him to steal, depending on his timing of it all. And we know Ty's still in the pool as well for Empire, and they could run him as an offlane. Up against Naga, probably not the easiest thing in the world. But they're going to ban him out nonetheless. Dire team ban. So maybe fearing that Na'Vi were going to run him offlane down towards that bottom lane if Empire didn't have something aggressive enough to deal with it. And Lashrak and Chen to a point are aggressive, but not aggressive enough to bring down a Tidehunter. So they let that one go for the moment. And the last ban to come out from Puppy. Doesn't have all the reserve time in the world. So he did get the penalty for it, but surprisingly both these teams don't even care about reserve time. And Puppy actually bans out the Beastmaster himself, so he's still looking at Empire's offlane. It's almost like they want them to go Windrunner. That's not a bad hero for Na'Vi to face up against if they run it that way. But Na'Vi could also look at Windrunner themselves. They got second pick, so they can't grab it immediately, but if Empire don't pick up their offlaner right now and they try and save their hard carry for the last pick. And we have seen Dendi run the Windrunner as a mid-solo. I've also seen offlane by Light of Heaven. Reserve time. We've seen it in many positions, really. Even seeing it support by, Arsart played as support one time. Empire, now for the first time, they'll eat into their extra time. They're just not sure about where this lineup is going to go and how their lane synergy is going to work as well. Chen and Lashrak, they're great, but you still need the setup from them. And are you going to try and make Chen a core? Or is Rubick going to be the core? Puppy hasn't shown his mid-solo just yet. So they're not 100% sure just how great Rubick's going to be there. And what if Invoker comes up? Rubick up against the Invoker. Rubick's great when he steals the huge abilities, or abilities that just let you just dominate in the lane. And that's when you start looking down the lines of having things like a TA there, because you want to steal the refraction, you want to steal her traps, you want to steal these abilities that let you control so much. And Rubick with an Invoker, it's like, well, I can get Cold Snap, and that's great, but Invoker can just give you two other abilities up his sleeves directly after he's already cast the Cold Snap on you. And that causes the issues for the Rubick. So it doesn't make him a great laner against him. Disruptor. And there's Disruptor from Puppy. So it does mean that Shadow Shaman's going to be played by Dendi in the middle lane. Disruptor for Arsart, Enigma. Well, then again, do we also start looking at a different scenario? I think it was Zenith that did it at the International, during the group stages of the International, where they run Disruptor as a solo mid. Was it him? No. That was Copenhagen Wolves, I'm pretty sure. It was somebody, and I know the chat will catch up in a moment's time and say, man, it was this, so everybody knows. But yeah, Disruptor can run solo mid, and it was definitely a European team, I know that. But Disruptor will run solo mid, and you get that Thunderstrike up as early as you possibly can, and it's just consistent damage, consistent harassment. It's also high levels up on a Disruptor. Chaos Knight seemed the last one from Empire, so a very, very Empire-ish pick. Good damage, and hard to control when it comes to team fights. It's one big thing that Na'Vi don't have a large amount of, and that's AoE damage. Shadow Shaman, because he's got his shock, and that's going to help him out. Okay, EG did it. Bulba from EG. See, I know the chat knows these things. I love you guys. Love you with an affection I shall speak often. As often as in frequently. Not as in lost parents. 5 seconds remaining. But yeah, Disruptor for a solo mid. It's an option, but I've never seen Dendi do it. But Shadow Shaman, I've seen him do. And that means we see aggressive Blink Dagger Shadow Shaman. So one way to do it. But Na'Vi's last pick is going to tell us a lot more. Are we going to see an aggressive tri-lane even from them? Do we see what? Puppy, show us what you got. You could run an aggressive tri-lane if you wanted to. Even Shadow Shaman, Enigma, and Naga could do it. And they will still go the Invoker pick up. So Arcos on the Shadow Shaman, Puppy onto the Enigma. which puts Light of Heaven on Naga. Phobos will take out Disruptor then. Yeah, there's DK. He's on there. And that means Dendi Invoker for the solo mid. But who the hell is running the off lane then? This is a weird lineup from them. It's a little bit more standard coming out from Empire, because we'll have Funnik taking the off lane as the Windrunner. Prepare Scandal, he'll be onto that Rubick. So we expect him to head in towards that middle lane a little bit later on. He is their mid solo for Empire. They'll be joined by Blow Your Brain, the normal semi to hard carry role player to come out from Empire. He'll be on the Chaos Knight, Silent onto the Lashrak, and that leaves our last one, Goblak. But he is well renowned for his Chen, and he'll be playing it this game. So it looks like right now we've got a bit of a weird lineup. This is not going to be normal. This is just babysitting. This is Danny babysitting Phobos so he can get down here. He's got six tangos. He's going to drop an aggressive ward. They already see Funnik down here. But there's a lot of heroes waiting to gank him up. And this is an impossible lane to stand on. This is an impossible lane to stand on. And maybe that's the reason why Puppy, he can take one of the creeps early on, but if he stays down here, three tangos plus five clarities, it's possible he might remain here down here with Phobos, but I highly doubt it. Arsart already starting off with the fun glitch ward. Doesn't physically appear. The ward is there, and you can like deep ward it. You just can't directly click on it because this little rock wall blocks the vision of it all. The battle begins. Dire dropped their own ward in for that middle lane. So watching Funnik's movements very, very closely. They want to shut down Line of Heaven, so it bounces out where they lose in the bot lane. And Puppy, he does take one of the creeps from this bottom lane. And Sarn's going to find himself a nice little haste room. Out of balance. The line's already been drawn by Puppy for DK. So Phobos, he'll end up finding Silent. I don't know who's really going to come out the better in that one. The ward gets dropped, and then it's just like, hello, Silent. And he levels up Edict to start with. Could be some significant damage being done right to Phobos right now. Munches on the Tango, tries to get back. There's one conversion, try and help him off. More coming in as well. But DK on low life and Silent. His haste rune is still going to work. This could be first blood. Turn around for a Thunderclap. Coming in range of that tier 1 tower. Sorry, Thunderstrike. Stop calling it clap. And Silent kind of wants to go for round 2. Phobos isn't going to give it to him. Then Dendi in towards the middle lane. So an Exort Invoker. We've only seen one of these in the series so far, and it failed absolutely horrendously. Not to mention, he's now going up against a big blast, pulled back in again by Scandal. So Scandal trying to do as much damage to Dendi as possible in this early stage of the game. Keep him low, force that salve out, which he's successfully done so. But Scandal's got a lot of damage himself, but with the space he's made, he's getting some good last hits in that middle lane, 4-5. Up against Dendi, who's 0-3. It's not a single last hit in for Dendi. And then Puppy, bouncing out with the jungle, but Chen does the same over for the Radiant side. And then down towards the bottom lane, whereas Blow Your Brain and Silent. Easy setup with the Chaos Bolt, then the follow-up stun from Lashrak. As long as that Chaos Bolt stuns over 1 second, then Lashrak has the time to cast and do his work. But Phobos is going to get very little on this bottom lane as long as the control is there. Can't come close enough to get experience as well, because then he comes in range of that Reality Rift. And the Reality Rift range, as you can see right now, is pretty decent. And now he's in range. Small moment like this where he feels he can get those last hits, and the only reason why I could think it is because Silent's looking for the rune on the bot lane, and they're watching him very closely to do so. The reason why they're trying to ward up this bottom lane so it's not an entire loss, and they don't give away first blood by doing it. One downside right now for Empire is just the fact they haven't managed to get themselves a kill. Now coming towards the middle lane, Goblet's going to see if he can turn that around. But Dendi not fast enough, really. First blood in the bot lane. They're trying to go on Dendi. Scanner will pull him back in again. Centaur follow-up stomp will do the job. But Dendi's up on the high ground. They can't afford any misses, and the test of fate is going to do the job. So Phobos goes down the bottom lane, and Dendi gets picked off in the mid lane. This is something you kind of knew was going to happen. Didn't really... Well, you kind of knew that bottom lane could have erupted at any point. But they're going to hope it can balance out with what Light of Heaven's able to achieve on the top lane. Arsart trying to get close enough for a Shackle. It's going to be max range if they do it. There goes the Ensnare. Shock goes as well. Now the Shackle should happen. Straight after the Windrun. Sunstrike from the Invoker. Going to team up. Dendi able to get that kill. A much needed for him. That's going to let him get that bottle up a little bit faster. Phobos now becoming a D-Water. Missing a lot of hits uphill. And you can see... He can see silent, but just this one ward here gives him just enough vision across this point. So feels good about that. Now top lane, Puppy with an invis rune. Again, waiting for this wind run to be popped off. So Puppy, body blocking him to start with. There goes the ensnare. Combining it with the Malphite, not the best chain of stuns. And now with the Sunstrike, going to go up again to get another kill for Dendi from the middle lane. Radiant's top tower is under eyes everywhere. This is almost classic Invoker. It's the only way this Invoker really works strongly, because it shifts the balance of control in this middle lane. The kill goes the way of Dendi. Top lane gets the experience as well as the control. But it switches the balance up, which Dendi desperately needed after the he died very early on in the mid lane. And now Scandal going to go for the rune. So a double damage rune for him. He's having a great time for that. But at the same time, Na'Vi try and look to do a little bit of damage early on. Bring down that tower. Another set of conversions popping up. Of course, Arstarts enjoy being part of these two kills on the top lane. Already up to level 4.5, which means we've got Serpent Wards a little bit earlier than we'd expect. Funnix trying to slow it down, but it's a level 1 power shot. Arsard taking up the tower for now. And fortification will happen again. Again, Disruptor falls in the bottom lane, but this could happen at any point. Radiant's top tower has fallen. The tier 1 tower dies in the top lane. It's just such an unstable lane on the bot lane. That's why I was questioning the laning choices here of Na'Vi. To throw Phobos down there basically accepts the fact that he's going to die. Now Sion and Goblack looking for an opening, and if you get that troll trap off on Dendi in the middle lane if they want to really claim this, but it can be set up by Rubick. Just look for that range on the telekinesis, and Dendi holding back in the tower, and the one thing that's going to help right now is the 3 points he's already put into Quas, but he's trapped in, eating damage as well. Dendi is trying to let off any kind of damage he can on the Scandal. He might even get this kill. The tower's attacking him, but the coal snap wears off. Wasn't enough in the end, and Scandal will be forced to walk all the way back to base. But that'll just give time for Silent to get some experience in the middle lane. While it is going to be line of heaven up here on the top lane. Getting in whatever farm he possibly can. It's also great for Funnik. Funnik, he's getting levels. Where Disruptor, he's got very, very little. Glimpse plus the Thunderstrike. That's still enough to say on the bottom lane. Look how aggressive Empire's being as well. Blow your brain, just running in, getting inside the trees. I think he was hoping if like there's some vision around here, maybe he can get a reality rift and pull him up. And DK, now he steals the haste rune. So Scandal gets denied, and Scandal also level 6, so he steals that call snap. But call snap, which is only a level 1 call snap, that's the reason why I didn't really do that much against Scandal. And Dendi will just use it for a little bit of harassment, but that's all. Only 1 point in Quas means that call snap doesn't hurt that much. Fabolt again, this is just frustrating the crap out of Dendi. This is so much of his damage, which he just switches to Xor to try and balance out. And then back to the Quas, you see the negative 26. Might have been the only reason why he tried to go the Xor, so he can still get last hits in the middle lane. Silent looking for runes, or looking for something. Puppy looking for a kill, level 6 up on him. And what else we got flying out? Tell me it's boots. Yeah, it's boots in a ring. So now he's got the movement speed to get in. And Scandal will be the one he wants. And they got to get the kill before Scandal comes out, because then he'll steal Black Hole and return the favor. And support can easily TP into that tier 1 tower. Not that it really has to. Funnik as well as Sion have already rotated in. So they're looking for a kill again here on Dendi. So it's going to be counter initiation. Both teams want kills in the middle lane. So Scandal with the pickup. Now in comes Puppy. Going to look for the hole. Three grouped up. Malvestone going on Scandal. He's still held in range of the tower. Now the black hole going to hold Funnik. While Silent runs away, Dendi's going to focus here on Funnik. The car wall is up, but Dendi's too far out. Blow your brain, TP it into safety. And be glimpsed away, so he can't do any more damage. But Invoker for the Rubick is the ending trade. And looks like there's still some more fun to be had with Silent Puppy limping himself out. Blow your brain searching for the kill. Earn Charge will keep him up. Now he's going to find Phobos. Arsark coming in. 3 points in the shock, plus having the Hex and the Shackle. But CK unable to find his target. Puppy just moving perfectly. I'm hearing Sunstrikes. I'm thinking that's not coming out from Rubick. If it was, it'd be searching for Puppy in the jungle. TP's come back, so yeah, it was Dendi's. Fade bolted again, and now Sunstrike is stolen. This is when it becomes a bit more of a fun time, because now CK becomes even stronger. 225 damage coming out, because he takes what basically is the strength of the Sunstrike, the strength of the ability. If their opponent casts it at that time, it takes that strength. So if CK gets a stun down there on the bottom lane up against the Disruptor, that Disruptor is dead. So he'll be stunned, Sunstrike straight away. Arsart managed to get a little bit of a snipe off here. Finding Lashrak a long way out of position, and now he's looking for Scandal. We're going to go another Sunstrike, and then Fabled it down, but they come in range of those Smash Servant Wards. I think Funnik wants to farm them up a little bit, but had to use Stick Charges to even live comfortably out of that, knowing that the Sunstrike can be returned again. Denise is on cooldown for the moment. If he had vision of that Windrunner, he might have been able to get it. And oh, really? No! Oh! Oh! What the frack? How did he even know that? Is it the ward? Oh, man! That is so BS! Now middle lane, Denny getting a taste of his own Sunstrike. Scandal wants to try and finish it. But you can see Windrunner, and Funnik's going to be spitting chips. He ran up, he ran down, he went around, he came back up again, and then walked down this direction. He tried to stall out as much as possible. But Dandy kept his cool and got it. And Puppy in the meantime, free farming up inside the jungle. But Scandal, what's he building up towards? Phase Boots already? Courier flying that one out? Yeah, Courier's flying out the Phase Boots. Goblack, he's looking pretty good with 1k. Probably Arcane Boost to start with. Obviously not as fast a farmer as Enigma, because he requires to convert the creeps he wants to farm. And he has been involved in a couple of kills as well, where Puppy, the times which he's moved out of the jungle, has been very few and far between. At the times he does, he's normally been involved in a decent fight. Now Arsart, using haste, gets the Hex up on Scandal. Wonderful ward trap up from him. Sunstrike turns around, but that wasn't the right thing. He pulled him back out of it, but Chen! Beautiful play there by Goblack! Gets the Rubick back out of safety, and Scandal have only had a couple of moments to live after that. And that means Mass Serpent Wards are down and out of range of the tower. So great play from that, then Sunstrike to go and damage down Puppy. The wall starting off too, blow your brain, finds Denny's coming in from behind. Silent can't walk through that, but Denny's still going to go down. CK able to hold on to him, now Line of Heaven goes up against Lashrak, Pulse and Edict. Blow your brain, pulls him back out again. Fantastic play by Empire. Na'Vi on the retreat, the Naga Olmos currently on cooldown. Not what they want to have happen. It's going to be Phobos getting called out again. Blow your brain, hexed up. No mana left for Arsart, he still wants Light of Heaven. Probably going to pick him up too, and there we go, last hit. One last Riptide out from the Naga. But it's not enough to bring down Blow Your Brain. Four heroes lost by Na'Vi. And Empire looking great right now. And that's the urns now done for Blow Your Brain. Attempted Sunstrike again. Looks like it's happening towards the middle lane, looking for Scandal. Puppy returns. Black Hole's back up again. Now look for maybe an opening. But while Puppy's by himself, he can't really do much more. And Denny's even going to leave that lane. He's not getting levels, he's getting ganked up too much, so he moves up towards the top lane where the tier 1 tower doesn't exist for the Radiant side anymore. Leave Puppy towards that mid lane just to control it. Silent, looking like he wants to give some kind of momentum towards that bot lane, but Arsart's already rotating down 10 seconds on his wards before he's capable of using that. Light of Heaven trying to find some farm inside the jungle. And DK had a decent stack coming out of here. Maybe this was their intentional strat. Use a Thunderstrike to farm that up, but Disruptor just doesn't have the levels to really make that doable. Sunstrike's going again. Searching for Scandal, retreating out of the middle lane. Looks like Puppy had some fun with him. This is also a good time for Puppy to farm in the middle lane. So saying he's building towards that mech, and now he's only 250 gold away from it. And Goblack, well, he's actually looking pretty great as well. Now I'm to level 8, Hand of God's already there, but his mech is only 400 gold away. So really decent farming coming out from the Chem. Considering they haven't claimed a tower, and Na'Vi are currently one tower up. It's even better as far as the income goes. What's actually our gold per minute coming out? Chen, sitting at 228, where 332 coming up from Puppy. 332 is probably going to come from more consumables before he managed to get the Soul Ring up. And now in towards the middle lane. They see a disruptor there, but it's not the real one. Checking out the Roshan pit, Blow Your Brain looking for a kill. But Enigma's left. In fact, all of Na'Vi has left that lane, so Blow Your Brain spending a lot of time looking for a hit here. But there's nobody to kill. No one's on the bot lane, it's just everybody's inside the jungle for Na'Vi. They've grouped up as four, and the conversions, the first ones coming in. Fortification trying to slow them down. Sunstrike. Very, very randomly placed. I think it's just Denny had the mana for it, so he may as well use it. Now they're going to try and get rid of the Chen creeps. Blow Your Brain still waiting for that time to jump in. They don't know he's behind them, but if they find out, there's no ward, there's nothing to look for it, and the courier not flying that path for it. They want to jump this. I'm talking about they being Team Empire. Scandal trying to come in close. Picks up Puppy. Naga Roman going to pop off. Nothing to really chain, even if Blow Your Brain jumps in. Ward's going down. Now the black hole. Blow Your Brain wants to pull Puppy out of it, which just does so. And Rubik turns the black hole around. Three caught in. Then the Shackle from Funnick as well. Chen's on low life. Arsard's going to fall him to the deck. And that's through the Urn Charge, bringing him down. One last stun out from Puppy. Trying to slow down Blow Your Brain, which it does do so as well. Held inside the net. Line of Heaven's on the run, but Blow Your Brain will die back past the tower. Power shot, niggles on Line of Heaven and Puppy, but just pulling out of the range again. But looks like Dendi was hunted down. Why the hell did he end up all the way down there against Scandal? And that's the power of the Rubik. Rubik just able to steal anything at a moment's notice. Damage. So we're looking to go again now. Blow Your Brain heading up towards the top lane. Maybe he can find himself a kill up against Light of Heaven. Puppy trying to get back into his farm routine. And they spot Blow Your Brain with a double damage rune heading towards the middle lane. So instantly Arsart forced to fall back. Knows he can't stand on this ground. And Dendi, I think he just... instant defensive abilities up. Get that Quas, get that Ice Wall. Down towards the bottom lane. Goodbye, Phobos. Actually, nice glimpse away. But gets picked up by a Scandal, pulled down again. So the wall comes up again too, trying to lock Sarn in position. This isn't what's meant to happen! This isn't the plan! That's the plan! In comes Phobos, Shackle is up too. So he gets locked down, and Arsart just walks in to Blow Your Brain. 2 seconds stun, then just one crit. Denny will slow him down, but while that drum chant is gone with the phase boots, Blow Your Brain doesn't feel it too much. And he'll keep on chasing down Denny past that tier 2 tower. Again with the cold snap, trying to stop it so he can't do his proper combo. And also cops a little bit too much damage from that tower. Top lane TP tries to happen. Puppy TP's in towards the middle lane. Reality Rift again, this time on a Denny. No cold snap. Might create fortune before he dies. Puppy with a mech charge, gonna keep Denny alive for now. Blow Your Brain again with another Reality Rift. Can't do it, goes on Puppy instead. Puppy, mech charge on cooldown, not gonna be enough for him. Cold snap doing what it can, but Lashrak's done even better. Hand of Gold from Goldblack keeps the rest of his team alive. And that means they can turn around and look for Arsard again. Four staff down, but can't get him close enough. Blow Your Brain glimpsed away, wonderful ward trap. So Goldblack blocked in position, they're just well, fighting the way out there. The creep saved the master. Tier 2 tower was lost on the top lane, so Line of Heaven was able to take that out. But this is a great game for Empire right now. Over 3k worth of gold going their way. More for the experience, but 7k for that little sucker. Denny gets a return now with a 4 staff. Light of Heaven. Unusual position. I'm guessing Rubik had a little bit of fun with him, throwing him up onto a cliff. And now the blink dagger comes up from Rubik too, so good initiation to come out from Scandal. Should see what Puppy's drawing right now. Keep that farm going between the lanes. Naga so far behind the what farm she needs. 329 gold per minute does not get you a Lincoln Sphere by this point. Still use that Alden Orb plus the recipe on top of that. And Blow Your Brain starts again. Yasha is up on him. He's having a great time. Tries to Reality Rift to catch up to the Forged Spirit. Probably hoping he'll still in range of Dendi. So he can get that Chaos Bolt off and then follow up with the damage. We're going to go down the middle lane. Maybe they're going to try and force a Phantasm's on cooldown so they can't force too much. But Chantan of Gods off cooldown in 13 seconds, and they got the mech on top of that. While Silent will pressure the bottom lane. Force Na'Vi's attention to defend the tier 2 tower while you take out anything else you can find. And maybe find a snipe off. Look for that Shackle, then the Reality Rift. It's all they really need. Puppy, what's he up to now? She's Pester got nothing. Strength treads. With his mech, with his Sol Ring, nowhere near a Blink Dagger. Same with Shadow Shaman, he's just walking around with Arcane Boots. Doing what he can for his team, and Na'Vi realizes pressure on the bottom lane is a little bit too much. So they're forced off to the side, but now they've instantly got to get back towards that middle lane, because that's the opening Empire was waiting for. Silas now rotating towards the middle lane. He was the one giving that momentum out. Blow your brain. Juking around in the fog of war here. 4 seconds on Light of Heaven. Glimpse goes absolutely nowhere. ZK. Phobos gotta be there to protect Light of Heaven. Now he pops the ult, but not where he wants to. They'll get Sarn as well as Goldblight together. Ward trap down again. Puppy with a black hole, but instant shackle from Funnick. They knew that had to be coming out. Nice Sarn wall up there from DK, but it's not gonna be enough. Goldblight on low life. Now the black hole's returned. Pulling in Puppy, pulling in Light of Heaven. Scandal's on low life, though, being call snapped up by Denny. And then the shackle follows up, holding Denny plus Poppy's corpse together. Now Denny four staffs up, able to find one extra kill. Double kill for them. Riyarif gonna pull Phobos back in again. All Denny can do is watch and maybe even die. Blow your brain with a Phantasm 3 second stun. It's gonna be an ultra kill now to blow your brain. Beating down Na'Vi, causing a genocide against the Dire, and taking the tier 2 tower. Coming back to farm up in the middle. And they probably will take Roshan and not push into the base just yet. They know all these ultis are on cooldown. That was that combo from Na'Vi that had to hit, and it just did not. They're thinking about Roshan, and they're thinking against it by the looks of it. Go back out and farm a little bit more. Be sure Boy, your brain gets your Manta maybe before the next engagement. But his Phantasm is back on cooldown with the Mass Illusions. And this is going to be Empire's like little bit of a card to get into the base. Sure, they can do a decent amount of damage, but you need those shields. You need those heroes that can be on the front lines. And normally going up against a large amount of Manta Illusions or Mirror Image Illusions of Naga Siren, you get caught on this line. But you get the Phantasm units in, they can just walk up, and just by themselves, the amount of life points they got, the amount of damage they do, they can bring down these towers to easily half life with just one set of Phantasm. And you just go again and again and again till you get yourself through. Now push to the tier 2 tower on the bot lane. Na'Vi trying to ride the defense. Serpent wants it back up again. And we do see the Disruptor ult, he's up. So let's have a roll. And our shot, as well as Split Earth, instantly takes out the creep wave, which means it's a full edict. Blink up, shackle to follow, absolutely perfect. Puppy will get nothing off in this. Maybe he'll get a mech off in time. Silence on low life, taking up the tower when he dived through that one. Back over to the net up, which was started up by the Disruptor, holding Blow Your Brain in position by Light of Heaven, was trying to beat there. Might have to pop the ult if he wants to save his teammates right now, and he will do so. Denny can't do much more apart from this, and that shackle finally wears off. They've just got to retreat and let the tier 2 tower go, but blink up by Scandal, follows up on Light of Heaven, then the Sun can follow up, but he turned to a chicken for the moment, but it won't stop him from diving into the base. Reality Rift won't happen, and Scandal on the tail of Shadow Shaman, and Shadow Shaman blocked himself into a corner. Shackled and nuked by Chen, or shackled by Funnick, nuked by Chen. And Invoker, Denny, the only one alive for the moment. Tier 2 tower is still up, and maybe thinking he can catch somebody out of position here. Power Shots keeps giving them the vision. A mass open wars on the side, but welcome to Mana Star plus Phantasm. This is a very clear message that they're going to keep pushing in. But Deafening Blast causes some issues. Let's want some damage towards this tower, and don't believe it can be held off. It's that time for the Thunderstrike, and this is the damage which we're talking about that can just destroy tier 3 towers. And that was just the Mirror Images going in. Nothing. Wasn't even the original. But that's the reason why Phantasm is his ultimate. Now Na'Vi in a lot of trouble. Even more trouble for experience. 26 to 12 is what we're looking at. Light of Heaven still just cannot find any kind of farm. It was a buyback by the Lashrak, buyback by the Rubik. But that kind of cash, Empire's got to throw it around. Now they're looking to look for Silent. Got to get this right. Funnik is here, but the damage already is done so fast to Silent, and he will go down even with that pulse. Four star by Funnik. I think he didn't really mean to four star for conversion, but he went with it nonetheless. The only good thing that's gone the way of Na'Vi in the past couple of maybe 10 minutes. That one kill on the top lane. And Vlad's now coming out from Chaos Knight. Makes the push even harder to defend. It's going to be Midnight Pulse, it's going to be Thunderstrikes, and even then, that's only level 2. 75 damage is very minimal. And Dendi's Deafening Blast is the only other significant counter they've got against that kind of push. Well, Arsart, he does have Aether Shock as well. So maybe that would be enough. So while those Phantasms do a significant amount of damage, they can also turn around and just die straight away too. They don't have a lot of life to play around with. I see, they take double damage. So imagine every single hero against you has double damage for spells as well. Now you blow your brain. Starts up on Poppy. Forcing a stun. Forced him down the hill a little bit further. The images are there, and that's why we see that Deafening Blast pop off. Four-star Vin now. Blow your brain. Instantly hexed up the second he gets there. And there's four spirits and conversions. Really focusing on Chaos Knight. Want to pull him back in again. Light of Heaven. Will pop his ultimate. Now Puppy's going to come in. Can't find a good target. The Ward Trap is up and blow your brain. He's going to hold Funnik this time. You shackled me before. I will nail you this time. But Scandal steals the black hole. Turns it around. He got Light of Heaven. This is the best one he could have gotten. Maybe the Steed Charge is not enough to live through it. Naga the only one to go down. But Funnik wants more. Double four-star up. Looked for Phobos as well as any to be in line, but Denny, staying away from trees, now going to go Invis. They can't find him. What you cannot find, you cannot kill. They can still push it out in the middle lane. That's what they're going to try and do. Denny's back in base. Silent was chasing down Arsart. No TP, so he won't get back in time. This is tier 3 tower in the middle lane and possibly the full racks. Fortification doing what it can. Forge Spirit is trying to get rid of these freaking images. That's what they're focusing down to start with. Now Puppy, conversions are up. Look for the tower, Shackle won't latch. Tornadoes are also here from both sides. So Na'Vi, they're fighting against the elements as well as Team Empire, who now focus on the melee racks. Naga returns to the world of the living. Possible TP in, but there's no black hole. There's no ultimates at all from the Dire side. And you still got Hand of God and Mech up. Na'Vi just don't have the damage, don't have the fight. Now the entrap is up. Dendi jumps in. Wonderful tornado combines it with the meteorite. Wonderful. Oh, Shackle. Perfect. Perfect on a Phobos. But the Sun's got a lot of issues for blow your brain. Cole snap dump. Still living on 112 HP. Dendi wants him. Four stars in the middle of the Empire team to get it too. But they can't find it. Now they're pulled back. Scandal on low life. They want him. Light of Heaven was looking for one hit, but not going to get it. Well, so we've already got a TB back out to base. Was it Chen pulling him back out? Well, the only way he could have done that in the midst of all that engagement. Now blinked down by Dendi. Gets the ice wall up. Four staff down with the wind run. Now the call snap. We've got to keep those right clicks going. A Scandal. He's now stolen the trap. There's nothing to shackle Dendi too. And Na'Vi are hunting for the kills, searching for blow your brain. Heading up into the jungle, but with the extra movement speed that he's got, nobody can catch up to him. So all this chasing equates to very, very little. The TP, the send out was actually from onto Lashrak. And that's Chen just knowing the right one to pull out. Now up towards the top lane. Light of Heaven, Puppy. Too low on life, he's held in position. Sunstrike's gonna be run on top of Blow Your Brain. And maybe Light of Heaven has the damage to do this. Glimpse him back in again. Holds him in the wall. Blow Your Brain's not gonna get out of this one. It will be a death, maybe with a Phantasm! Oh, he disintegrates Disruptor! Now San's gonna come in with a Pulse and Edict! Chaos Knight with a double kill and buy straight back into the game. Make the most of this while Disruptor's dead as well as Puppies on the sidelines. And when they both come back up again, they'll have their ultimates and the Enigma Black Hole be back up. Wonder's Rubik walking around with at the moment, still walking around with Ensnare. Sunstrike. Just scanning for Scandal. That's just the Illusions up trying to get that farm. Using the Riptide to do it. The top lane push is going to come. Fortification on cooldown for the moment. And Na'Vi are nowhere near prepared for this. They're trying to heal up. Blink Dagger 4 Staff. Dendi has got to make the most of this Tornado Meteorite again. and blow your brain. Look how far he comes up. 4 seconds done. Glimpse him back. Now, Light of Heaven gets the oldie off. TP in. It's coming from Puppy. He's got to hold that. Chen as well as Funnick in position. He only gets Funnick, however, and Scandal steals the black hole. Oh, it's going to be bad for Puppy. They don't want to use it just yet on him. They want the rest of the team to go down. There goes Phobos. Some being brought down by Light of Heaven. Will finally happen. Shackle kills him off. Denny on the position. Blow your brain. Double kill for him. Vinebag now coming out from, it's actually Latrak coming back into the fight. Arsak will get out of range to blow your brain. And the ward's focusing on him. On the run back out, Light of Heaven now has a snare off cooldown. Threw it out, keeps those illusions on the front line so he can Riptide, but he can't do so while he's currently being held in position, so the illusions get taken care of while that shackle held him there. And 32 to 15, currently sitting at this point where Na'Vi, they're running out of bags of tricks. Their ulti combos are not working, and that's the power of Rubick. Pull back in, Arsat, and then the crit through, and GG is the call. Na'Vi's first game will be recorded as a loss. They will have to go up against Scandal. PTT! Happens right now. And there goes Scandal. A sacrifice. The only upside of the kill right now, he jumped in. So the team's getting a little bit more fun, but Na'Vi, they have a matchup against Quantic in about 10 minutes time to see if they can post themselves a win on the board. If they cannot, they will go 0-2. And Quantic, they're not a team to be messed around with of late. Puppy already called the GG, so this is over. No fake GG calling, especially when Chaos Knight comes in, because they know this is going to happen. At the end of the day, you cannot face up against a Chaos Knight with this level of farm. Blow your brain, able to achieve 20 for 1 in this entire game. 134 was his CS for 30 minutes in. But just that 20 for 1 on the kill counts. Dandy as well as Funnick playing around inside the jungle. Forge Spirits as well against a Dandy? I don't know, 2 seconds and 4-star. It's anyone's fight. Dandy still wants it. Chasing down Funnick. He's lost a lot of armor, but Funnick plays it on the high ground, and then TP's out to safety. They won't get the kill. But it will be our GG, where the main base going to take a fall, and there she goes. 36 to 17. More action will be coming up shortly. As I said, Quantic going to go up against Na'Vi. A game not to be missed. Really, no Dota game should ever be missed. So stick around. We shall return. See you soon.